On message. Not the best of breaks there, though.
There's two ways to execute a cut break. Generally speaking, that's a three-quarter ball hit, medium hard, with body action, or cutting it a little more, spinning the cue ball, just like Nick Ewen did. It's more like a soft medium, medium hit. And I think the latter is harder to execute consistently. He has a shot on the one, and he has Efren as an opponent. Does he want to get involved into a safety battle? He did win the last one. It's a world of difference how close you position a cue ball behind the blocking ball. I don't think Efren has a route in between the rail and the four ball. He's masseying into the rail. What a shot. Great shot. Actually, I must say, it is a great shot, but the rail, in this case, helps. It makes it easier for that cue ball to hook towards that one ball.
Well, they call him the magician, and we've just seen one of his tricks.
Containing safety, at least the object ball safe, and maybe the bonus. A two-row escape over the right side of the table for Efren. He's favorite to hit the one ball, but of course he would like to play a resafe to make something happen here. Towards the four. Wow, what a shot by Efren. He chose the more difficult path, one rail, but with a bigger probability of getting lucky. That's what he always says, I got lucky, but the more I practice, the luckier I get.
Nearly. For the cue ball, jarring in the jaws of that top pocket has really helped Efren Meyers. Really helped. His tactical mastery and ability to see a shot that no one else can, I think, is unparalleled. There, though, fortune helped.
Beautiful. You can't beat that. A big miss there by Nico. Was not an easy shot. You'd expect him to make it.
Yes, especially after the momentum gained from that one. And so Reyes should have the simplest of propositions to run out and make it 2-1. talking about the World Cup of Football right at the start of this match, of course, Alex. Efren Reyes and Francisco Bustamante won the inaugural World Cup of Football, and their popularity in their native Philippines knows no bounds. Put the shoulder into that, not exactly technically textbook, but it worked.
It's not a jury sport.
It sure isn't, but there, Efren Reyes found guilty of pulling Iraq back. He trails 2-1.
好，现在是轮到了瑞斯的冲球。好，冲球有球进啊！这次好像不进则已，一进大概一起进了啊！<笑>一二都进，然后三号球哇，就在母球的前面，太好了啊！哇，进了，好像三个球啊！<笑>我们看六号球进了，二号球进了，
对，一号球进中袋啊！这个就是。 这个一号球进中袋啊，就是他们这些选手啊，这个选择的这个袅袅冲的一个最大的原因啊，这个因为由于这个一号球啊比较靠近球台的中央，所以说呢啊进中袋就更容易了啊，比原来的原点要进中袋就更容易了。好，四号球，
哎，拉杆啊，这个拉杆走了这个三颗星上去啊。 好，这个球以这个五号球的角度来看的话，必须在拉杆啊，左塞拉杆两颗星走到七号球的左边啊。好，拉杆两颗星弹上来。好，继续的拉杆回去，一颗星弹出来，哎，哇，角度做那么大，哇，会不会有什么意外？ 好，这个球可能必须要走两，母球可能要走两颗星了啊！这个不管打哪个带，都要走，可能都要走两颗星了。用推杆的方式，好，看他下左塞啊，下左塞推杆，好，没问题啊，下左塞推杆走了三颗星，弹了下来，再多走一点点。 好，保左下脚底带，好，看看有没有什么特殊的打法。好，球杆还够得到啊，所以说不需要特殊的打法。我们在过去曾经看到他把这个球杆放。
世界花式撞球大师赛这场八强的比赛。
Last break of Efren, he made two balls, but no third ball crossed the line. He needs to add some speed. Okay, this is a legal break and a perfect shot on a one. This should be a wreck point for Efren. Could be a good wreck for him to gain momentum, to pick up some rhythm.
He's playing in England for the first time since 2006. Now, a marginal favourite, you would say, to make a winning return. He's never won this World Masters title, one of the few big events missing from his CV. But compatriots do have their names on the trophy. Francisco Bustamante in 1998 and again in 2001. And Dennis Okolo in Las Vegas in 2010.
Breakfast, the six.
Here we go. The six is the wing ball.
I'll tell you what, I'll lay two breakfasts to one. I'll tell you, that's about the percentage. It's been going 8 out of 10 times. and maybe the one in the side also. Oh, he made the one in the side anyway. The six missed by here.
Okay, very quickly, you can see that the three is open in the lower right hand corner. The four up table is the coupon. The five ball is to the right hand foot spot. The six is really left hand middle. The side pot. The seven is underneath the black end. The six and the seven. Short race to seven, and the difference in playability is, in fact, the difference in quality of play between these two players is very little in playability, particularly a short race to seven. And Reyes is considered the best player in the world today, but Luka Kimmel is a far
better. He was ranked number one in the last couple of years. But here's the big thing about this short race.
Well, shots over at Ferguson. He said that's a win, so that was a tough shot.
Also works as a booster of confidence. If you know that you have figured out the brake and the speed and that you will be getting shots, that gives a lot of confidence. Add to that Efren Reyes not getting position on the first shot after the brake a couple of times. The 4 and 7, good place to hide behind. Doesn't need to attack from here. And the 8 comes into the equation also. I don't think the snooker is there. I think Immonen can get through to the two ball. Just thinking, you know, as Reyes went back to his chair there, it's impossible to calculate how many racks of pool he must have played in his life. He must have come across virtually every eventuality and played in some extraordinary venues, both in tournaments and for hard cash. What a story he could tell. After that, he might be playing for a while longer here in Barnsley. A 3 will pot. It's tough, but it goes. Intricating choice of shot by Immonen. He had a straight shot on the 2, could have played a draw shot to leave himself straight on the 3, which seemed to pass the 9 ball. Never threaten to the pocket, Efren Reyes. That is the harsh part, that with age, his B game is weakening. But now and then, once and again, he can still bring his A game. So it's very tough for him, I suspect, to accept the lack of consistency. Yes, Reyes falling victim to exactly the same thing that snooker players find themselves falling victim to as they get older. Even the very best, their potting from distance and also their ability to concentrate for sustained periods declines. People assume that tour players and aging snooker players aren't so successful as the years go by because of deteriorating eyesight. It is a factor, but I think more important,
the ability or the lack of ability to concentrate, and the fact that the pots go astray. Plus, of course, you pick up more and more mental scar tissue.
So here we have it, Efren now needing a lot of action on the cue ball, over distance. He cannot play with topspin, it will kill the cue ball there. Oh, did he make that look easy. He cheated the pocket there, pocketing the three ball in the side of the pocket, thereby creating an angle and enabling him to hit it with stun. Stun draw, a lot of left-hand side.
All of those hours and hours of playing as a youngster, a teenager, then in his prime. Now when he's regarded as the grand old master of the game. And regardless of the result here, it's great to see him back on British shores.
Using his stroke not to force the angle, but to control the angle. Top players leave angles. They try to avoid a position like this. Immonen had a shot for the match. It was that long cut and the three ball, which he mishit. So after all the mistakes, it will be 7-6.
That's right, and
make no mistake.
So, 这比赛是采取抢七局制。好，那么现在二号球啊，可能要来一个中杆推杆啊，推一点点啊，推的差不多五公分左右，来做这个三号球的中带。好，我们看啊，一个中杆推杆啊，母球刚刚好往前走了五公分啊，相当漂亮。那么为什么要往前走五公分呢？啊，这样子的话，做三号球，打三号球才可以很顺利的来做到四号球。 好，我们看他往前推啊，往前推的话呢，大概就是要推下来了啊，推到台边啊，来做五号球。好，推到台边下来啊，弹一点点上来。好，那么六号球当然是来做另外一边的底带。好，六号球做了一个大角度的球啊，这样子的话。 好，这个薄球啊，看看是走一颗星或者两颗星啊。这个七号球做上方的底带。好，看拉杆走了两颗星啊。当然，这个走一颗星或者两颗星啊，这个完全要靠你刹车的这个能耐啊来决定啊。如果说你认为说这个球太薄了啊，这个直接走一颗星刹不了车，那你就必须要走两颗星了。 好，控台啊，力道控制的非常好啊，做到了九号球。所以我们看到这个 Efren 打球啊，这个速度非常的流畅啊。当然啦，这个一方面当然也是信心的问题啊，一方面也就是这个对这个整个啊这个环
Reyes。
what he's doing.
Excellent observation. And he hit it right on the head. That great two-ball control.
And I've been talking for days about when you're going to snooker a guy, it's way bigger if you freeze the guy on the ball you snooker on because it takes away a whole bunch of tickets.
No, that's the strategy. That he can see are the 9 and the 3. And I don't believe he can tie up either one of those two. So therefore, he has to do something. Now look, he's going to shoot your shot.
Well, I hope so, because you're supposed to know the shot. Look, you've got to have it in your repertoire. This particular situation, if the elevator's coming
out. Well, what he wants to do, he wants to hit the rear on the bed.
He's elevating.
No, he wants to hit the rear on the bed.
Oh, he's going to go past it.
这个年年的这个波兰，这个 Warpulik 对，都是陪绑的。但是这一年呢，感觉他进步很多。
对，每一位选手都会进步啊，然后高手也会老啊。
哎，一号球呢还是没有进左边的中袋，留下一个大的 chance。
哎，有球进啊，我们看进的是。二号球进了啊，
对，
好，那么现在一号球，但是跟母球距离太近了啊，有没有办法进攻呢？好，从这个角度来看，看不出来啊，因为我们看不出来母球跟一号球到底的距离是多少啊，这距离是个关键啊，距离太近就没有办法进攻的。好，有一点点距离啊，但是母球有没有办法闪过中袋呢？
现在要进这一号球，他觉得应该不是问题了。他现在大概是在想如何来做三号。
不是，这个母球会进中袋啊，这个母球搞不好就进中袋了。
对，小心啊，
这个有点
好，看看，好打得很薄，哎。
哎呀，
这个球一号球进了。
好，那么三号球可不可以过呢？三号球如果过不去的话，那就来打一个三九组合球啊，可以过，
可以过，
啊、
对，
清楚啊，非常的清楚。待会儿看看四号球在哪里。
四号球在上方啊。现在米卡伊莫的每一球都要步步为营，非常小心啊，因为他已经没有在后退的本钱了。
好。这个球还三号球打得非常不准了，借九号球进的嘞。如果说观众刚有仔细看的话啊，三号球打得非常不准了，借九号球进带的。
而且呢，刚才呢母球撞到六号球啊，现在母球停在球台中央。做到四号球左上角底带，不过是一个大角度的薄球。
好，这个哇，母球必须要闪过八号球啊，看看有没有办法闪得过去。
小心，
好，拉杆，好，只好走这个路线了啊。那这样子，我们看看过得去吗？
嗯，要不然可以来打一个五七的组合球了。
对，因为刚刚啊，刚刚为什么不推杆走到五号球的右边啊？当然，最主要的原因就是因为八号球的位置有可能会挡住母球，所以说啊，他才。只好来走这个路线啊，走左边的路线，好，过不去啊，就做安全球了啊，这没有办法的事情。
好，我们看看现在应该还解得到啊，在 Rios，
哎，可以打得到啊。问题是怎么样子来做安全球啊？这个，当然我们每次啊，每一次不管是看 AFN 的这个比赛，或者是说跟他比赛啊。每一次都可以学到一点东西啊！这个因为 A friend 他真的是一位天才型的选手啊，这个安全球的路线啊，或者是说这个其他解球的路线啊，那有时候啊都会让我们啊这个相当的惊奇。
对，很多球是他打完之后，大家才想到哦，原来可以这样打。
对，有这个路线啊。
好，看看他这个球直接可以解得到。
好，下低杆啊，打八号球，准备利用六号球来吊球啊，力道控制得非常好，这球，好球，漂亮，一个漂亮的低杆左扇啊，低杆左扇，
嗯，看他有点很不满意啊，那
大概是太好解了，
对，
好，看啊，可以打得到一点点，虽然说没办法进攻，但是可以让对手打到，他就非常不满意了啊。
五号球呢？这个画面上现在左边的这个角度已经被六号球给挡到。
好，看看要不要来灌底弹。好，还是打安全球啊！打安全球的话，哎呀，放呛死了啊！
哦哦，
放呛死了啊！这个球啊，其实米卡伊缪你可以尝试来灌底弹啊。Fabio Petroni， 还有
Alex Lady， 还有 Bustamante。
好，打进绕球台出来，哦，漂亮，哎，过头了啊，好，过头了又必须来绕球台。好，那么现在这个球可以来走一个，可以走一个左塞啊，左塞中杆左塞啊，然后母球走两颗星啊，或者是三颗星啊，沿着左边啊再下来，我看看是不是走这个路线啊。好，下左塞啊，我们看啊，沿着左边下来，好球啊，这是一个中杆左塞的路线啊，
好球，左上角两颗星之后，现在做到了七号球，那么这场比赛呢，应该要结束了啊，
对，
要结束了，
差不多了啊。
好，现在我们看到 Reyes， 哇，对，刚刚出炉的世界冠军。这场比赛 Reyes 已经47岁了，面对28岁的年轻选手，这位 Mika Immonen 打起来可以说是四平八稳啊。那我们看到这场比赛呢，
最后一个九号球，
对，打进九号球，结果他以大比分呢，而且比赛还蛮悬殊的，7-2打败了 Mika Immonen， 要追就很难了。这是两位选手第一次在世界花式撞球大师赛里面的交手，
好，我们再来欣赏一下这个袅袅冲啊，看看一号球会不会进中袋。好，哎，
又进了。
对，现在因为现在已经两位选手都已经有冲球的经验了啊，第一局两个人都冲不进啊，然后从这个第三局开始呢啊，当然这个都知道怎么去控制力量了啊，然后瞄准什么点啊，所以说这个当然一号球进中袋就变成了理所当然的事情了。
不过现在二号球呢可能呢比较难进攻啊，那我们看看 Mika Immonen。
好，这个哇，这个组合球不好打啊，为什么呢啊，因为五号球贴着台边啊，这不好打。好，果然没进啊，这是一个难打的组合球。
哇，放枪死给对方了。
对，好，那么这个现在这个组合球就非常好打了啊。
对，
这个几乎闭着眼睛就可以打得进了。
就是少林必死的球。我们看到二五的组合球打进，那现在二号球继续同样一个带，三号球就在它上面。
好，那么三号球考虑一下是要做上方底带呢，或者是说要来做同一个带啊？做同一个带的话，当然打半颗球啊的右塞出去啊。那如果要做上方底带的话，就稍微打厚一点啊，打整颗一点。好啊，我们看到打半颗球一颗星上去啊，做同一个带啊，这是比较这个一般来讲九号球选手的一个比较合理的做球方式啊。当然啊，我们过去看到很多斯诺克选手啊，碰到这个球有可能三号球就会做上方底带。好，那么现在六号球是不是来做中带啊？看看四号球是什么角度啊？直球直接拉杆啊，直接拉杆回来做到中带，再轻轻的推杆啊。
伊莫呢，他今天也是偶有失误啊。那刚才的那个二五的组合球没打进，结果现在。
对，基本上来讲，他刚刚的那个二五组合球拼得有点勉强啊，因为那个球，我们刚刚已经讲了，是一个非常难打的组合球啊。
对，因为五号球贴在台边呢，他的切线的角度呢，感觉是不合理的，但是他刚才勉强进攻，结果付出了代价。你看，现在呢 ，Reyes 准备要把比分拉开5-2。那这样对于伊莫兰来讲，他虽然贵为当年的世界冠军，但是
有时候也是要靠球运啊。有时候这个比赛也是要靠球运。
他一个比赛一个比赛状态都可能不一样啊，这必须要一些个别来谈的。现在5-2，在伦敦 Lakeside Shopping Center 所进行。